Hello, this is my tutorial of a Loomigurumi pencil. So basically this is what it looks like. It's pretty like short and round. This is my original design. I created it a couple months ago, but I wasn't able to post it till now. So that's what it looks like. You can add a face if you would like, but I don't have any eyes. If there's anything you have a problem with, like increasing, decreasing, doing half rows, or like this nib is a little confusing, I will do a tutorial. I will post a little Loomigurumi basics video, and a Loomigurumi video just to show you stitches and other things. The band count will be in the description, but the band count here is a little off, I believe. The band count I have says 396, but maybe more around like 420, 410. But the band count down in the description is just going to say 396. Here's everything you'll need. You're going to need a hook. I'm using Rainbow Loom hook. You can get this from Michaels or Amazon or their site. I got mine from Amazon. You're gonna need bands. You're gonna need around like five different types. Yeah, you're gonna need five different colors. You're gonna need one for the eraser, one for the metal part, one for the painted part, one for the wood part, and one for the lead. I use the original colors except for with the metal part and eraser. You can use any colors you want. You can even make this a colored pencil. I have made it a colored pencil before, but I kind of sold those ones, so I don't have it to show you. Let me see. I'm not sure if I said, but you do need a C clip or stitch marker. Okay, you do need a C clip or stitch marker. I have my stitch marker right here. That's everything that you will need. And if it's really hard for you to count how many rows you have to remember, you're gonna need at least 9 stitch markers so that you could leave it in to know how many rows you did. But it's not hard for me, so I didn't need to do that. And that's everything you need, so let's just get into the video. Okay, let's get started now. Start with our eraser color. I'm gonna be using orange. These bands aren't from Rainbow Loom, they are from Wonder Loom. I don't really recommend them because they're not that good. But you can use whatever bands that you have. So we're starting with the eraser, and first we're going to want to do a magic ring of 6. So just take your band and wrap it around your hook 3 times. Sorry if I was out of frame. Then pull a band through, reclaim, put the back one over the front one, go back in, do all 3 bands of the cap band, pull another band through, keeping the back one in the back, reclaim and pull the back 2 over the front one, and then go back in to the cap band, pull a band through, reclaim, and pull back 2 over. So we're gonna do that 3 more times, or until you get to 6. And when we get there, I'll show you how to count, and I'll put our cap band on. So I'm gonna go relatively fast because I showed you what to do. Okay, let's check if we're done. Okay, so this is the count. I start from the hook. So the first one on your hook is a stitch, so you count 1, and then you count all these little teardrop shapes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then you're gonna grab your C-clip, S-clip, or stitch marker. I'm using the C-clip because that's what I have, and then put it on the hook, on the band that's on your hook. So now we're going to increase all. Just decide to do increase if you don't know. go inside the next stitch. Don't go in the cap band, go inside the stitch that's like right here. And don't go in this because to some people this looks like a stitch, but it's not. Go here. And then pull one band through first. And do basically what you do in the cap band, but inside the stitch. Then you have one stitch inside the loop. And then go back inside the loop and pull one more band through. And that's how you do an increase. Once again, you pull one band through the loop, then you pull another band through the loop. So you pull two bands through the loop separately, not at a time. And you're just gonna do that all the way around till you get back to the cap band, and the cap band to the stitch marker. Sorry for background noises. That's my sister. So just go all the way back to the stitch marker. And you're also gonna do an increase on the stitch marker loop, because some people don't do the increase on the stitch marker, but I do. I think it's like better and less confusing. So just go one more time. Also, the band count may not be very accurate. I think it doesn't take how many bands it says. I think it takes around 400 and not just 300 bands. So once you get there and do your increase in the loop that has the cap band, you're gonna take the cap band off and put it on the band that's on your hook. Then you're going to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You should have 12 loops. No. Now we're going to increase every other to 18. Basically, you're just gonna do a stitch and then increase all the way around. You're gonna repeat that. Also, be careful because sometimes you may think you did increase or you think you did a stitch when you messed up and did a increase. And it's pretty easy to go back. I'm probably going to do a Loomigurumi's basic video. I know I said that a long time ago, and I know I haven't really posted to my account that much, but I'm starting to post more on my Instagram and everything else. So hopefully I'll start posting on here more. I'm not sure if I already posted this tutorial, but if I did, then I'll like fix it, but I'm pretty sure I didn't. And I have more designs coming. I know I posted one of my designs on Instagram, but I will redo it on here and repost it. Okay, I'm halfway done. And then once you're done, like I said, once again, you're going to have a... you're gonna have 18 stitches, so this adds 6 to it. Just gonna keep going around. Sorry if I'm not in frame. There, we should end on an increase. If you don't, then that means you probably made a mistake, like you forgot to do a normal stitch or an increase. So just check to make sure you didn't make any mistakes. Oops. So just increase on the loop that has your stitch marker, and once you're done, you can take off your stitch marker, put it on the band that's on your hook, and now we can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Now we're going to increase every 3rd to 24. So basically do 2 stitches and then increase. You stay every third because, like, after you do two normal stitches, you do an increase. And then after this, after this, we won't have to do any more increases. We won't have to do any more increases. So just keep doing two stitches and then an increase all the way around until you're back at the stitch marker. And I will just talk because it's pretty simple what we have to do around. Please follow my Instagram. I post a lot on there, like almost every day or after I do a after I make a Loomigurumi thing, I usually post it on there. That's like the only other thing I use. I used to use TikTok a lot, but not really. I don't use it as much anymore. And I haven't posted that much on YouTube. I've been really busy with a lot of things. And school, because school started for me in August, so I haven't posted there much. And it's really easy on Instagram because I just have to finish my thing, snap it, and then upload it. Let me think what else. And I'm also starting to gain there fast, like get more followers. And Rainbow Moon followed me, which I was super excited, and my mom was also excited for me too. Hopefully I can get 100. Right now I think I'm at 37. I think yesterday I was at 34, but I gained some more followers.
Okay, so we are grounded in the basement.
And I have been, I was working on some designs, but they didn't really go through. I was going to make a crab design, but it didn't look that good. So I decided to scrap it. I was making a snake design. I haven't finished it. I finished mostly the head, but I think I made the head a bit too sharp. So I'll fix that, and hopefully I can get it out soon. I'm hoping to make a two-headed snake. Okay, we should end on a increase. So let me just do that real quick, and then like you're always gonna have to do, move up your C clip or stitch marker up to the band on your hook. Let me just move it real quick. Okay. So now you're going to do three rows. No, two rows of single stitches. I will do one row with you guys, and then you guys can do the other row. If it's hard for you to remember how many rows you did, then you could leave your C-clip in and get a new one for each row, and then you could see with how many rows you did. But it's not really that hard. I usually use bands to mark it, or if it's something really short, like it's only two rows, then I can remember pretty well. So, this is doing one stitch in every single loop. I'm also sorry if the background noise is louder because of my sister. I would much rather be recording in a quiet place, but I have no other place because I have my baby sister with my mom in her room, so I can't go in there. I could go inside the bathroom like I've done once, but people have to use the bathroom. And the live room isn't a good place either because my roommate is in there watching shows. So being set up here is way better. Sorry for that loud noise. That was my sister. She just left the room. I'm hoping to start posting on here more. And I have some things that I want to post. I'll probably do a update video showing what I've been doing since I haven't posted and what I'm going to post and what I'm hoping to show you guys and what I'm hoping to get done. And probably I won't post so much in November and December because around that time my school is like we have to do a science thing, so I won't really post that much because I have to work on my science project. Hopefully this video won't take up too much space because my iPad's been really, really low on space. That's why I don't really post stuff, because I don't have much space. Okay, almost done. You should end on a single stitch because we're not doing any increases or decreases. So once you're done with this, I'm gonna pause my camera and do the other row, and then you can unpause the video and come back. Okay, so I'm now done, and we're not. Oh, sorry. Okay, so I'm done now, and we have finished the eraser part, and now it's time for like the metal ring around a pencil, which I'll show you guys here. See, I have a pencil to show you guys. So this is the eraser, which we finished, and here's the metal part. Our metal parts are gonna be this long. It's gonna be super short though, because I don't really like how long the metal part is. So you can use gray, silver bands, or gold, whatever color you want to use. I'm going to be using gold because I have gold. And these are Rainbow Loom bands right here, not Wonder Loom bands or Amazon bands. Don't forget to move up your stitch marker. Actually, so take off your stitch marker and take your hook out, pull one band out. Don't pull out more than one, which I'll just slip that back. Take out one band, grab the color of your metal, and then pull the band through the loop and pull the back one over, and then reclaim and pull this back one over, and then put your stitch marker back on. That's just to have a clean clean switch of colors. Now we're gonna do a half row. I don't really know why I did this, but I'm gonna go with my tutorial I made a couple months ago. A half row is where we don't go inside of both loops, we just go inside of either the back part or the front part. So we're gonna go into the front part all the way around. Basically, to do that, you just stick your hook into the middle and push it forward. And as you can see, you only have one side of the loop on your hook. You're going to do that all the way around. It's basically just doing normal stitches, but only going into half of the bands. Half of the band. I'll show you guys one more time. Go to the middle and push forward. And that's how you get into the half row. And if you guys have any like ideas or designs that I should make, like maybe we should make a cow or a heart or something like that, I could try to make it. And if you guys comment anything, yeah, I would try and make it. If I think it's like a super, super good idea, I would probably stop the projects I was doing then and do it and then post it and give you guys credit for the idea. If you guys like helped me, like if one of you guys say make an alien or make a big strawberry, then, and if I'm like, oh yeah, that's cool, I should make it, then I'll try and make it. But I'm kind of low on bands, and the only reason why I have Wonder Loom bands is because I sell stuff at my school, and I didn't have any bands for my for the people who ordered, and I had like 5 orders that I had to finish, and I didn't have any bands. So what I did was I went to the store and bought those because they were the cheapest, and Rainbow Loom bands didn't have all the colors I needed. So I bought these, and I don't like them. Oh my god, is there a spider on my bed? It's okay, as long as I don't mess with it, it won't mess with me. And that's the only reason why I have these Wonder Loom bands. And I don't really like using them because they usually leave my designs looking bad, because they leave like holes in it, basically. And it doesn't look good. But the customers, I told them why the things didn't look to its best. they're like, they understand. Because my mom told me she was going to buy me bands, but she didn't have enough money to get the bands. Well, she did have the money, but she said, but she was really cheap, and she was trying to tell me that she was gonna take off a pack of bands, but I told her I really need those ones, so I was like, never mind, I'll just get the bands from the store, which I think I should have just gotten the bands offline. Actually, no, she said she was gonna buy all of them, but they're only gonna take until the next month, and I didn't have it long, so I just went to the store. But a plus side is that my grandma gave me $20, and my mom gave me $25, so I ended up getting $45 and spending a little less than half of it. Like, I spent like $18 or $16. Okay, this is my last thing. So, at the last one, so since we did a Slipknot, there's like this little thing right there. We don't want to go into that. We just only want to go inside of this one. And you're going to pull the band through. So sorry for the loudness. That's my mom getting to feed my baby sister. Okay. There are people outside my windows. My neighbors. Okay, now... this is your one row. This is the one row that we did so far. We're gonna do one normal row, so it's not gonna be a half row. It's just gonna be a normal row around. No increases, decreases, just normal stitches in each one. Hey, I ended up going through my C-clip. Okay, wait. I'll do this with you because it's not gonna really take that long, but I won't like tell you guys how to do it step by step because it's just one row around, and I'll just finish talking. And yeah, that's the only reason why I have these ones and bands. And since I'm doing a tutorial, and I use most of my bands on my dragon, which you can see on my Instagram, which I'll put right here for a couple seconds. That's why I had that there. Also, I'm not sure if I said it in the first part of the video, but I will be having the design down below. I'm pretty sure I said that in the beginning of the video, but I will be having that down below if you do not want to watch this video, or if you want to stop watching this video because I'm talking a lot. But I'm almost halfway done. And then you should end on a normal stitch because we're not doing any decreases or increases. I think in the beginning I rated this, like the hardness, a beginner, which it pretty much is. I think even my mom could do this because my mom's a beginner. She did make RTD too. It didn't really look that good, but it was her first design. And then she didn't have the right hook, so she made this duck, and the hook was way too big, and it just stretched out all the bands, and it looks very funny. It has a bunch of holes in it. But she did pretty good. It did take us 6 hours, but it was because my baby sister had to keep stopping to feed her. She kept messing with stuff or crying. And also, my mom's projector didn't have speakers back then, so it was really hard to hear. But now we do have speakers. And she also didn't really understand the tutorial. Also, if I am sniffling, I am a little sick. And if I was inside the camera view, sorry, but it's still, we're just doing normal rows around. Like I was saying earlier in the beginning of the video, I'm hoping to come out with some tutorials. I was gonna make a crab, like I was saying, but I scrapped the idea, and now I'm working on the snake. I finished the head, but I'm thinking of how long I should make the body. I think it's kind of gonna be like a super 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 small version of I think it was by Isolus Designs, but I'm not sure. Sorry for the loud noise, that's my sister. Okay, once you're done, wait, you should stop on a normal stitch and wait, let me pull my band through, and then lift up, take off the thing, take up your stitch marker, put on the bends on your hook. You should still have 24 because we're not going to be doing any, we didn't do any increases or decreases, so you just have 24, and this is what it looks like. So I'm going to see what we have to do next, and I'll be right back. Okay, now, you're done with the metal part, so it's time for the painted part. This is going to take the longest, as it's going to be the most amount of bands. I'm going to use yellow because I'm trying to go for the traditional pencil colors, except for the metal part and the eraser. I'm using yellow, like I said, and then you can use any color you want. So get your bands out. I'm just going to pour some on the table. I might need a little more or a little less than this. Okay. Like I did last time, you're going to take out your stitch marker. You're going to take out your stitch marker and you're going to take out one band because I did too much. And now go and say next stitch you're supposed to be in, pull a band through and pull this one and set the middle two, and then just do a slip knot. Don't pull it tight or else it won't look good, and then put your stitch marker back on. Now we're gonna start with a half row so that we can make this look like it's popping out. So instead of going in the middle and then pulling that out, we're now going to go through the side like this and go up so that you can see now that you have this outside one. So just pull a band through, and we're gonna do this all the way around. So go through the side and then up. And you're gonna do that all the way around. While we're doing this, I'm gonna show you guys a couple more times because this might be a little more confusing than the outer half row. So go in through the middle halfway, then push up and out. And that's how you get one side. You're gonna do this all the way around until you're back to the stitch marker. And while we do this, I will continue talking because it's pretty self-explanatory what you have to do all the way around. As I keep saying over and over again, if you guys have any ideas that I should do, I'll make them if I can. And most of the time, the first prototype is going to be inside of mismatched bands because it's easy for me to use old bands than to use my new bands. I'll probably post a bracelet tutorial today or in this week, and maybe I'll post a my ice cream cone tutorial. I don't really like the longer one. I like the smaller one because it's way cuter. And then I'll also post a mini cherry tutorial, which that should only take me a couple minutes because it's not really that hard to make the cherry. And then I'll probably post a Loomigurumi's basics videos, like how they increase, decrease, special type of stitches. And then I have some projects I want to do. Most of them are big. If you see my Instagram, then you'll be able to know the projects I want to do. And then I have some fall and Halloween projects, and Halloween is going to be in like a month or so. And it would be really nice to have like some mini little Halloween and fall things since we are getting into fall. So I think September, October, and November are all falls, all the fall months. And then once you get to December and January, December, January and February. That's when you start getting, that's the winter months. And I already know what I want for Christmas. I knew what I wanted for my birthday, like a month before my birthday, but I ended up getting different things, but I know like what I really want, because I started doing Loomigurumi around my birthday. So once you get back to this stitch marker, you're gonna do one normal band inside the stitch, and you're not gonna do half row, because I don't think you need to. Also, make sure not to go inside the little slip knot thing. So now, this kind of looks like a candy corn, but now you have this little thing, this little row. Now we're gonna do 9 more rows. I'm gonna do 2 with you, and then you could do the other 7 by yourself. This is the part, this is the time when you wanna set up your bands, if it's hard for you to remember or get something to count. I'm gonna place down 9. We're gonna place down 9 bands inside a little line, so that I know that's 7, 8, 9. Okay, I'm just gonna take the 9 band because I don't really need it now. And I'll do 2 rows with you, and then you guys can do 7 rows by yourself. And we're not gonna do any type of special rows. You're just gonna do 1 stitch in each, which is pretty self-explanatory. So I'll go pretty fast, and I'll be talking during this whole thing. Like I was saying, I want to do some things, some little fall themed and Halloween themed things, but I don't really have that many bands. And I think I want to make a Halloween design, since Halloween, like I was saying, is in in a month. I'm really excited for Halloween, and then Christmas is going to be soon. Christmas is in like 3 months. And I'm thinking of starting a SD again, but that will be in a while, because the last time I started one, I wasn't getting any sales, and I also, they're also charging a lot, so I'll probably do that once I get a lot more followers and people know about my account. Okay. Just had to make sure that wasn't a band that I was using to count, because sometimes when I do Loomigurumi, I set up my bands way too close to, I set up like my counter bands way too close to my actual bands, like the bands I'm using for the row, and then I end up pulling one of the counter bands, which is not good, because then I think that I did the mini rows. But it's actually really easy to count, which I'll show you guys how easy it is to count. I don't know what's going on here. Seems like the stitch got stuck, so I'm just gonna skip a stitch because I don't know how that happened. Okay, I'm gonna do 1 more row with you guys, and then while I do this 1 more row, I'm gonna talk about how I started doing Loomigurumi, because I think I started doing Loomigurumi in like February or March, and I still have my first ever thing. I'm never gonna get rid of that. I'm always gonna keep my first ever thing, so that I can like show myself, oh yeah, you know, remember when you first started, and then now. Oops, I forgot to do my counter band. And I'm very proud of myself how far I've gotten in the past couple of months. And let me think. In like 5 months. So I've been doing Loomigurumi for like 7 months now. So in about 5 months, it's gonna be my 1 year of doing Loomigurumi. And that's gonna be very exciting. And I think maybe around that time, I will do a giveaway, because I can save up in like 5 months I can save up enough money to have shipping and also be able to get like a couple packs of bands. And hopefully in about 5 months I will have more designs out, because I want to do something like how Ginger Cell did, or if not, I will just like let people share my stuff, and then after they share it, I will like put them to a random name generator and do it that way. But I really would like people to actually like have to do and see my designs to win some bands. And I might do 3 winners, and then each winner gets like 2 or 3 packs of bands, or I might do 5 winners and each winner gets like 1 pack of bands, or like 10 packs of bands. But you know, buying bands is kind of expensive, because I think I was buying 20 packs of bands and it came up, no, I think I was buying like maybe 10 packs of bands and it was coming up to like 15, but that's not too bad. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm probably basically gonna do what Ginger Cell did for her contest. But that's gonna be in a couple months. And I know that I've been posting that I wanna do a giveaway. So I think once I do my 1 year anniversary of doing Loomigurumi, then that will be the perfect time to do the giveaway. Because around that time, I'll be better. And I'll probably have money saved up, and or I'll have bands from Christmas. And then I think maybe I'll do like a giveaway every year, or each year that I've done Loomigurumi. So if I keep this hobby, which I'm hoping that I won't like get disinterested in it, I'll keep doing it for years to come. So I did 2 rows with you guys, and there is 7 more rows to go. I will do the 7 rows off camera, so you guys can pause it now, and then I'll come back and show you guys what to do next. So this is how you count how many rows you did. You could count from the outside, which is not really that effective. Like, but if you were doing something in a full color and you didn't know where you started from, so pretend this is all yellow, and you didn't know where you started from or how many rows you did, like normal rows, no increases or anything. So counting outside wouldn't really be that helpful, but if you still can, you could go inside, and we're still pretending this is all yellow. We look for where you did last of the increase, if that's what you did, or like here, we don't need to, we just need to see how many we did. So you start from here and you look for these little like things. It looks like they're holding things. So you count each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you see that I did 7 rows. So if this was all yellow, I would look for my last increase or decrease, since I did all the rows, and I would count up. Now since this isn't all yellow, and for like from here, I haven't done any increase or decreases. I can easily tell, and I can also easily tell from the outside. But that is how you count how many rows you did. If you forgot or you didn't have counters like I do, you see my 2 counters. Right now, you should have done 9 rows. So all together, we did 10 rows in yellow. I'm including the half row that we did, and then the 9 other that we just did, or the 7 other because I did 2 with you guys. Now we're going to be doing the little wood part of the pencil. We're going to be doing this part of the pencil. So I'm going to keep this pencil handy, so if I need to show you guys any more things. Now we're going to get our wood color. I don't have any wood color because I spend my money on boxes, like boxes of bands, so you can't really choose from them. I'm gonna be using this glow-in-the-dark orange from the glow-in-the-dark, the glow-in-the-dark mega box. You can get the glow-in-the-dark mega boxes. Or like boxes at Michael's. I'm not sure about Walmart because when I go to my Walmart, I only see Wonder Loom, which I'm never buying again. Hashtag never buying Rainbow Loom again. I just hurt my wrist doing that, but like I always do, take off your C-clip stitch marker, go back into pull the other band, take off the band that had your C-clip, your stitch mark on it, go back in, grab the color of your wood or next color, pull it through the band on your hook, reclaim, and just do a normal slip knot. Don't pull it too tight because it will look bad. And then just put your stitch marker back on. So we're gonna start with decreasing every form. So I don't count this, the first stitch, I don't count that one. So we're gonna do three stitches and a decrease. Because decreasing every four means that you do four stitches. And after you do your four stitches, that's when you decrease. So I have to do two, but I need to stop real quick to move my band, so I'll be right back. I'm back now. This should be more than enough stuffing. One tip that I have is to not just like force it all together and like clip it into a small ball and then force it in there, because it'll be pretty hard and you don't really want that because it won't feel nice to squish if you do squish your things like I do. You could take off your hook if you want. Mine just fell out. If you are worried about this coming off and it like unraveling, then you could secure it, but I don't really want to because if it falls off, I know what to do. I'll just stuff it. I use my two fingers to make sure that I get stuffing in, and then I like rip the stuffing apart to make it fluffier. So I'm gonna finish the rest of my stuffing off camera, and when I'm done, I'll come back. I'm done stuffing it now. We're done with the wood part. So we're now going to do the lead. We're gonna first start with, let me see. One row, I'm only grabbing the first part of the stitch. Wait, let me do the thing I always do. So take off your stitch marker and take off the band that was on your stitch marker. And then take the color for your lead or whatever color you're using and just do some knot. So we're gonna do one row, only grabbing the front part. Wait, let me see. Okay. Okay, I see what we're doing now. We're actually gonna decrease until closed with the lead. I was looking at the wrong part because the photos I took of the pattern were a little confusing. So we're gonna decrease everything with the lead color. So if you're making a colored pencil, you would use a colored lead. And if you're making a normal pencil like me, we're going to be using black or gray. Okay, oops. Almost done. So, the lead part isn't that big. So, since we're going to be decreasing to a close, you could just take out your stitch marker. And this is not all we're gonna do. So once you get to this point, we're gonna go like this, you can see. Go inside of this like that and pull a band through. Now if that was a bit confusing. Oops. Oh well, it came out so I can show you. So you go down in there and then you go underneath and pull up. And then you could just pull a band through. And you could do this all the way around. That makes the lid way bigger and less small. This is gonna be, after this I'm gonna do one more, and then you can tie it off, which I'll show you guys how to tie it off. So, I pulled it through way too many bands. Take your band, pull it through the little stitch, and basically just pull the back part over, reclaim, and you should only have two loops. Put the back one from one. Instead of doing a loose one, you're gonna pull it super tight. Then you're gonna do a band. So I don't have any, you could add eyes if you want, but I don't have any eyes with me. So I'm just gonna end the tutorial here. If you make it, I would really like it if you showed me. Here's my Instagram right here so that you could tag me. Like I was saying, if you guys have any ideas of what I should make next, then you guys can show me. Thank you for watching. Bye.